something that is probably, you know, running through your mind is how much study is required to be a successful creative artist. I want to actually kind of tell you a little story here through this, and it's called The Irrationality of Artists. It's a true story. Existential versus instrumental economics. I had an experience a few years ago where I spoke to an MBA class about public investment in the arts. In the course of the exchange, the class teacher mentioned in passing, there were several instances in economics literature of how much education someone would pursue. According to this model, people went to school until they realized that they could not regain their investment of time and money in their working lives, at which point they left the educational arena and entered the labor force. The big exception, said the teacher, was artists who continued to study long after the prospect of any possible financial benefit. Hence, the irrationality of artists. One economist explained this to me as the difference between existential economics and instrumental economics. Existential economics focus on experience, quality of life, and the state of one's soul. And all of that relates to our context in humanity. Instrumental economics prioritizes consumption, especially as it satisfies basic physical needs and urges the creation of wealth.
Values, you know, what it is that this country has.